30th of March 2021, Flexi Dynamics Holding IPO'd on Busan, Malaysia. The share price issued at 20 cents, but it started trading at 69 cents. That's 245% gain on the first hour of trading. Flexi Dynamics was not the only one with such performance. In fact, all companies that went IPO this year recorded stellar gains on the first day of trading. IPO is one of the most exciting events for both investors as well as business owners. Hi, I'm Frankie. Today, I'll be answering questions from investors and business owners all about IPO. Question 1. Why do most IPO stocks have big returns on its first day of listing? When a company decides to go public, for the first time, investors are provided with information about the company's history, how it grew from zero to hero. It's like your first time getting into a relationship. Your lover will only portray the best side of things to attract you at the point in time. Moreover, IPO prices are usually fixed at a slight discount to its peers in the stock market to attract you. These two factors are usually the main reasons that lead to stellar performance of IPO stocks on their first day of trading. Question 2. Why do companies go public? Every business starts as a private company. When a company is private, it is usually owned by very few investors. Now, how much capital can you get out of this group of people? Peanuts! But once the companies go public, you are opening up that business to owned by a large group of people, potentially tens of thousands of them. Going public raises a lot of cash for the company. With that money, you can do wonders to scale and grow your business. Question 3. Since the return is great, should I invest in IPO stocks? If you are a long-term investor, then it falls back to fundamentals. Do you think it is a good business? Can the business grow larger with the new funds it gets from the IPO proceeds? However, if you are looking at short-term gains, based on Malaysia IPO statistics, you have over 90% chance of making stellar gains on the first day of trading. But there's no guarantee that all IPO stocks will do well on their first day of trading. So, the risk is on you. IPO investings can be very lucrative. Personally, I know certain institutional funds that invest specifically in primary shares only, such as IPOs or private placements. So yes, it's rewarding if you understand the rules of the game and you know how to play it well. Question 4. How do I increase my chances of getting an IPO? I'm sure you know how to play a lucky draw game. In order to win, you buy more tickets to increase the chance of winning. When it comes to IPO subscription, putting in more money could sometimes increase your chances of share allocations. Well, just sometimes. Question 5. How do I evaluate an IPO company? Unlike public listed companies where you can look at their annual reports, there is no reference to an IPO company. Everything relies on a document known as the prospectus. After the company is registered with the Securities Commission and made its announcement on Bursa Malaysia, a prospectus will be published on Bursa Malaysia website. Once the prospectus is available, many research analysts would do a write-up to give their opinion on the company. At the same time, the company doing an IPO will conduct roadshows to meet potential investors to explain their business plans and convince them to subscribe to the IPO shares. To sum it up, there are three resources to evaluate an IPO company: the prospectus, analyst reports, and attending IPO roadshows. As a former investment banker, I had the privilege to participate in many IPO roadshows. I personally think that it is the best way to understand a business. Nothing beats hearing about a business of a company directly from the company leaders themselves. Question 6. I don't need to raise more funds. Why should I share my company with the public? Going public is not just about raising funds, but it also adds to the prestige and credibility of the business. As a publicly listed company, everybody knows about the business. It's much easier to attract best talents to work with you. It also serves as a free advertisement to find new customers. Banks are also more likely to lend to you because they have better access to your accounts. On top of that, since initial owners usually remain as the major shareholder of the company, they will benefit from the new valuation of the business. That's how businessmen got rich. Think of Mark Zuckerberg and Jeff Bezos. Their main source of wealth comes from the value of their company shares. Hiya! No need to go too far away. Just think about Mr. Tan Eng Kee. He listed his company Greytech Technology in 2019. In a span of just 2 years, he is Malaysia's newest billionaire. If he had kept his company private, he wouldn't have become a billionaire in such a short period of time. Question 7. As a business owner, what are the disadvantages when the company goes public? Publicly traded companies are subject to oversight by regulators like Securities Commission. And once you are listed, you are not just reporting to yourself anymore. You answer to all your shareholders. Yes. Even if somebody owns just one share in a huge-ass company, that person has the very right to know all about the business in which the company is involved. If your shareholder is not happy with you, you may be fired by the shareholders even though you are the founder of the business empire.
The fact is that you and I are sitting here today because this will be your last week of employment at this company.
A classic example was Steve Jobs, who got fired from Apple in 1985, having said that such regulations encourage check and balance among stakeholders in the business. So, although it may be inconvenient, it enhances the credibility of the company, building stronger trust with stakeholders, including suppliers, customers, and shareholders. Think about it. If you are doing business with a publicly traded company, I'm sure you'll feel more secure dealing with them. Question 8. How does a company go IPO? Going public is a painful process. It normally takes more than 6 months to complete the mission. Once the company has complied with all the listing requirements, the process begins with engaging an underwriting firm, typically an investment bank. The underwriting firm will put up the money to fund the IPO. Sometimes, they also look for cornerstone investors to subscribe to the portion of the IPO. After that, they work very closely with the company to determine what type of security to issue, the offering price, the number of shares, and most importantly, the right timing to bring the company to the public market. The underwriter is also responsible for making sure all the financial information of the company is accurately disclosed before registering the company with the Securities Commission. With that, the company can announce its public listing plan and potential investors can now start subscribing to the shares. By the way, many of you ask me how to subscribe to an IPO. Call your broker lah! You pay them to do work what? I mean, really, it's not that I don't want to explain. Different brokers provide different services to their clients. So just call them to ask about how to subscribe to a corporate deals. That's all we have for today. #FAQ.